Hey everybody, this is Fixer, and I have something new and interesting for you. The game is called Ark Survival Evolved. It is currently in Early Access. Just came out on June 2nd for $25. This is a dinosaur survival game, and now I know what you're saying. Double whammy, dinosaur game and survival, it's gotta blow, right? Well, as you know, there's a good deal of dinosaur games out there, and then there's loads and loads of survival games out there. And when I first seen this game, and I was the same thing. I was like, oh, whatever, another one. I'll pass. And the trailer looked good. I admitted that, but I didn't want to take a chance on it. And then it came out in early access. I saw gameplay on YouTube. I was like, all right, I'm sold. I'll give it a shot. I'll try it out. And the reason for that is that it seems to have a lot more content in it than other early access survival and dinosaur games. You know, when you see all these dinosaur games on early access and Steam, even the released ones, you can only get a handful of dinosaurs, 6 or 7. And I think this one has currently like 50, is it? Or 70 or 50, or and it will be 70, something like that. I don't know. Anyways, I wanted to give it a shot. And the way the devs describe this game is that you start stranded, naked, freezing, and starving on the shores of a mysterious island called Ark. You must hunt, harvest resources, craft items, grow crops, research technologies, and build shelters to withstand the elements. You use cunning and resources to kill and tame the Leviathan dinosaurs and other primeval creatures roaming the land, and team up with or prey on hundreds of players to survive, dominate, and escape. Now, this game can be played in multiplayer or locally in single player. Currently, there's an issue with single player where if you play the game, close it out, and then restart it, you can't get above 10 FPS. So I'm going to avoid that for now. I'm going to start on multiplayer until they get single player fixed. Now, this game is early access. There are plenty of bugs, and it is not optimized very well. Not yet, at least. So, to give you an idea, I run an i5 2500 at 3.3 gigahertz. I have a Radeon 290X. I am running it at 1080p on mostly high, and I get about 20 FPS. Now, I've played with all of these settings. The devs say the shadows, the sky quality, ground clutter, and the occlusion cause the biggest FPS hit. And I find even when I turn them off, I don't get much of an FPS boost. Maybe 1 or 2. So, after loads, I'm talking hours of fiddling around. This is the best I can get, and it's about 20 FPS. I get jumps to maybe 25, but it definitely drops to 15, 10 sometimes. So, I can't record this in 60 FPS yet. As soon as the game gets optimized, and I can run it at 60 FPS, then I'll start recording it in 60 FPS. But for now, we're in 30 FPS. Anyways, let's get out of here. Find myself a server. The official servers, as you can see, are pretty much packed. They're all 70 man. These show 0 people on them, but you can't get into them for some reason. So I gotta hop on an unofficial server. I'm gonna just find one with a low ping and a low quantity of players. I don't really want to interact with people when I'm playing this. At least not to start, unless they're friends, but right now it's just gonna be a solo affair. Alright, I'm gonna find a server and I'll be right back. Alright, here we are in the character creation screen. You can do male or female. We're going to do male here. Skin color, range from black to white, everything in between. But you can go even further to black, which is what I'm going to do. He looks kind of freaky. Hair color, not much of a range, but I'm going with white. Eye color, can see it go from blue to green. I mean, it's very minimal. We'll go with red, huh? These guys are giants, and I'm not so sure. I want to stick with it. Oh, come on. No, we don't need to see that part. There we go. I'm going to make his proportions a little bit more believable. All right, let's start with the chest. Let's bring that down a little bit. And the torso. There we go. The height. Oh, that's kind of weird. All right, let's bring it back to the middle. Shoulders, they don't need to be giants. Those arms, holy cow. All right, that's a little too small. There we go. Lower arm. Those are a little long, aren't they? There we go. And those hands. All right, now this guy obviously does not skip leg day. All right, let's fix that. His hips are a little wide. Here we go. Okay, that's about good. His feet are huge. Let's get those down. Torso depth. Oh, wow. Let's have a beer belly with a six-pack. Nice. That's good. His neck is pretty huge, isn't it? That's good. There we go. All right, that's a more believable size. His neck is a little long. There we go. There's not too much customization with the head. You can make him a fat head or a skinny head. Height. Oh, well, giant forehead. That's about good, I think. So he doesn't look like Conan the Barbarian. Now, let's get a fixer in here. Now, you can start on whatever coast you want. I do not know the difference between the coasts. I don't know if one is better than the other. So, I don't know. Eastern coast looks okay. Or western. Let's go with western. Alright, create a no survivor. Here we go. Wake up on the beach. And I got something in my hand. And that is about all you know to start off with. And it's too hot in here. I know you can jump in. I played for about... I don't know. I didn't play a whole lot. Most of the time I spent in game was trying to find a way to optimize it. So, just like Minecraft, you run up to the wood. And you punch it. And stuff goes flying, and that was a little loud, don't you think? Sound effects volume, let's get that down. Alright. So, you have to punch wood. I wish I could turn down the shaking I do when I punch stuff. Alright. And I know you can grab these rocks. Here we go. Not all of them, some of them. This one? Yeah. Alright, so... what was that? Oh, that's a snail. Well, a shell. Alright. We'll hop on over to inventory. And I don't think I can make a pick yet, can I? No. We'll hold off on inventory until I can make a pick. Alright, so these shrubs, these bushes, you can harvest stuff from them. You can see... tintoberry, fiber, stemberry, and these are edible berries. There you are. And berries and food in this game does have an expiration date. If you don't eat it within a certain amount of time, then it goes bad. It spoils. I think I need to make it to level 1 in order to make a pick. So we got some dinosaurs straight away. Now, I don't know too much about dinosaurs. Like their names or not. This thing is a Carbonomus? I don't know. And this is not limited to dinosaurs. There are other extinct animals on this island, like the dodo. He's so cute. It's amazing. And there are actually dragons on this as well. I don't think they're common. I don't know where you find them or anything of the sort, but I know that you can, I know they're here. So, as far as content goes, let's get some more wood. Fetch. Now, this does have a pretty robust crafting and building system. Now, I don't know if you guys have played, like, Stranded Deep or The Forest with their shelter building. This is... Oh, I can level up. So, leveling up, I have these stats that are all at 100%. And I think hitting a plus will add 2 to it. Now, I'm not entirely sure what exactly is great in this game. I have no idea what is better than the other. I know weight can come in handy when you're carrying stuff around. Health is good. I mean, it's nice to run. You wanna... What is wrong with me? Oh, I am on fire. I need to get in the water. Alright, so we'll choose weight. And now, I've got 8 points to dedicate to crafting. This is the hatchet. I don't see the pick. Maybe I can already do the pick. Oops. So, we'll do the hatchet. And I'm going to get out of here, save those points for later. I'm going to get cool. And there are sharks and other swimmy things in here. I'm still on fire. You see the lower left. On the right-hand side, you'll see at the very top, there's O2. That's my oxygen. The next down is my weight, how much I'm encumbered. Right below that, the water drop, that's how much I'm thirsty. That's my thirst. Then the haunch is my hunger. The lightning bolt, that is my energy. And the plus sign is my health. Alright, so craftables. We got my inventory here. And I got my wood, stem berries, fibers. You hover over it and it tells you what it does. So crafting, pickaxe. I need 1 stone, 1 wood, and 10 thatch. I can do that. Let's craft it. You select it and hit craft item. Boom, it's going to hop in my inventory. There we go. I'm going to put it on my bar. Let's make a... I need flint to make a hatchet. Alright, let's get back in the water. Alright. So you take the pick to a stone. And this is a little crazy. When you bust the stone, the stuff goes flying everywhere. There you go. And it's usually these big stones that you can mine. And this gets you flint. There it is. So I got enough now to make a hatchet. Let's do that. Craftables, hatchet, craft item. I can make a torch as well. Alright, let's get that hatchet in there. And what I want to try to do... Alright, we're going to chop some tree down. And what I like is the stuff doesn't fall on the ground, you gotta pick it up. It just automatically gets put in your inventory, and that's pretty nifty. Can I chop these down? I guess so. Now, I don't know much about the evening in this game. I haven't really been on the server long enough for an evening. Just like a early part of it. I don't know if you can sleep the evenings away. I don't think you can. At least not on multiplayer servers. Alright, that's probably enough. Alright, there's a new one there. Alright. Do a little more digging. Excellent. Oh, looks like Someone's got a base right here. This is a foundation. So in this regard, it works a lot like Stranded Deep, where you put your foundation up, and then you can put walls and then a door on it and whatnot. Now, the difference that this game has to Stranded Deep or something like Rust is that it doesn't end with straw, with thatch. I'm overheating again. I need to get in the water. You can actually upgrade your straw and thatch stuff to wood. What is that? Is that a little dinosaur? Oh, that's just a rock. Can I mine this? No. Oh, there we are. I guess that's... Is that a brontosaurus, right? So, when it comes to dinosaurs... Yeah, there's a brontosaurus. You can tame them? What? I just defecated. Really? I did not know this was in the game. Consumable. Oh my god, I just picked up my poop. Alright, now that guy's aggressive. I'm gonna stay away from him because I don't have a way to defend myself. Now, I don't know enough about dinosaurs to tell the herbivores from the carnivores. I know most of them were herbivores, and I know obviously things like the T-Rex is a carnivore. Or was the T-Rex an omnivore? I don't know, I think it was just a carnivore. Now I'm cold. Oh my god, make up your mind game. So, I'm going to play it safe and try not to interact too much with other dinosaurs, but I know eventually I need to because you need to get hide. I know hide is very important. Alright, I'm going to break my pick out because I need thatch as well, and you get more thatch from trees with your pick. There we are. This game, if you guys check the facts, I'm going to put a link in the description. The frequently asked questions for this game is giant. They have so much information out. I'm hot again. Ugh. I don't know how badly that affects me. There's so much information out there. Oh, wow. I'm having a heat stroke, I guess? Jeez. Of course, now I'm cold. Oh, there's, it's not a pterodactyl, it's the other one. What is it called? A pterodon. A pteranodon! Okay, let's go with pteranodon. Let's get some food in my bar. Zulberries and mejo berries. There we go. Works for me. I know some berries have bad... Oop, I leveled up. Alright. So, let's, movement speed, fortitude. See, I don't know what fortitude does. Or torpor. Water, food. So I'm going to go with weight again. And let's get started on building a house. Where is the foundation? There's the roof. Foundation. And the walls. Where are the regular walls? There's the wall. Door frame. And a door. And then we'll get a roof. Alright. So let's over here to my craftables. I can craft foundation. I have everything for a foundation. Let's craft it. And we'll go find a place to plop it down. There we go. I'm still running hot. Alright, there's a dodo bird. I know dodos have a pack mentality. So if you attack one, the rest in the area will attack you. I haven't attacked any of these large turtle guys yet. They look a little bit too tough for me. Alright. I'll probably stick to the beach here. I don't know. So I select my foundation, and then I can put it just about anywhere I want. Should I hide it back here a little bit? Maybe I'll do that. How about right there? There we are. Alright, so what do I need for walls? Craftables, door, wall. I've got plenty of wood and thatch. I need a lot more fiber. Alright, so I get that by taking the pick out of my hand, going after these plants. There we are. 5 fiber. That's what I need. That's a tree. That's also a tree. As far as cooking goes, I know you can build a campfire. And you can cook some monster meat, some dino meat on that, and get a lot more bang for your buck when it comes to eating. I think that's probably a good amount of fiber there. Alright, my first home. See how many walls I can do. Door frame, wall. Craft. 1, 2. Alright, so I can afford 3. And a door frame, I can do one of those as well. And a door. I can't do a door. Or can I? I can. Alright, thatch wall, we'll put that in 9. I don't think I got the frame, did I? What do I need for the frame? More fiber. Alright, so the walls we have on 9. And it shows the frame of the wall. You pick the side you want it on. And there you go. It's got the thatch on it and everything. Alright, so let's put up another. And another. See, it works a lot like Stranded Deep, although I think the interface is a little friendlier in this game. No, I don't want that. There we go. Need more fiber. That's probably enough. Can I get in here? Okay. I just pooped. I shit in my own house. Damn it. I wish I had more control over my bowels. Alright, door frame. Let's craft that. Still on level 3. I'm not quite at level 4. Alright, let's get the door frame in there on 9. There we go. Frame, and let's put the door in there. Boom. Can I walk straight in there, or do I have to jump? Oh, cool. It walks right in. Alright. So, I think I need more fiber and thatch. We'll get a campfire going, and as soon as I level, I'll get a roof. A roof? A roof? How do you guys pronounce it? And I don't know if... Oh, I need water. There are sharks in here, by the way, and... Oh, see, it's getting pretty dark here. Alright. Campfire. Can I do a campfire? Wall, foundation, hatchet. I cannot. And I only got 1. Alright, so... I need to do stuff to get my level up. There we go. So right now my game's running at about 15 FPS. I wish I could get higher than that, guys, but it's not really possible in this game yet. Check to see how my experience is going. I think this is giving me experience, right? 34.5. Let's chop down another and see what it does for us. Yeah, but not a whole lot. Alright, maybe, let's, mine some of these boulders. Maybe that'll give us... What do we have now? 35.6. Oh, yeah, that's not a whole lot. Alright, I think I'll break out a torch. Where are we at? There we are. Craft it. I was hoping for a campfire, but a torch will do. Alright, break that guy out. There we are. And I don't know how much this attracts dinosaurs, but there aren't too many aggressive dinos in here that I've come across. And this doesn't catch on fire, does it? No. Looks a little dangerous. Hold E for options. I haven't even noticed that. Oh, I can demolish. I don't want to do that. Set pin code. Oh! I didn't see this. Okay. Well, we'll use the same thing that's on my luggage. 1, 1, 1, 1. There we go. Alright. So, all I need now is a roof to protect me from the heat and from the cold. And now you'll see that there's these giant obelisks. I guess you can call them obelisks. And I... What's that? Oh, that's a seashell. Now, I went to one already in my single player. And it looks like you can spawn... What the hell is that? What is that? Fiomia? I have never seen one of those before. Alright, he doesn't... I'll get away from him. So these obelisks... It looks like, you can spawn, like, rarer dinosaurs in those... It's like you have to tithe certain resources to them, and once you reach a certain amount, then it'll spawn like a T-Rex or something. I don't know. That's just my assumption. I know that on the large servers, the 100-player servers, I think the one I'm on is 30 or 50. I know on the 100-player servers, you can actually go to your obelisk and transfer your items from one server to another. So that's pretty neat. Anyways, I think that about does it for this episode. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I don't know how multiplayer servers work as far as saving your items when you log off and back on again. I know some of them wipe you and some of them don't. I'm not entirely sure, but like I said, as soon as they fix single player, I'm going to hop over onto that. But until then, let me know how you guys like this. Again, this is Ark Survival Evolved. It is on Steam Early Access. For $25. Links in the description. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you later. Bye-bye.